All right. So on this video here, we're gonna do just a full gambit of daily activity. So this is pretty much what is going on right now. That's all I'm doing every day. So we, my wifey Waffle is gonna be carrying me around as I get the luxury of having a great person in the game here to really help things along. So this reindeer I have here, we actually joined like the top guild in the server yesterday called Royal, and we got lucky and got this this mount when they did the like the clan war. Yeah, we couldn't participate because we have to wait like 48 hours when you first join the clan, but we were lucky enough to have to get this bad boy right here. Yeah. That was very, very lucky. I mean, just joined at the right time because Waffles, she was saying, because we were in a dead guild, they weren't doing anything. She was like, hey, let's join a different guild. And we joined, I think, let me see, I don't know if it'll show the. Probably won't show the. I'm gonna show the other guilds, I don't think. Okay, but yeah, the highest person in here. So we got some we're definitely in a well guild. Okay, I'm at like 111, Waffles is at 140, so I mean this is a pretty decent guild here. I think they're pretty cool. Oh, they got two spots left.
Burn, no retreat.
What this activity is here.
Hey,
I think we're doing Dark Legion right now, I believe. Yeah, I believe we're doing Dark Legion. So a lot of times, you'll see what's gonna happen here. When we get to the boss, since we don't have a tank, it's only me and Waffles in here, like the healers are all Waffles state.
Oh, there you go.
We have to switch off that one.
Wake up, Teddy.
This is one of the few times where, well, I don't know if it's just because of the skills I have on. I don't have on my normal skill set that I'm not pulling the aggro. But I'll switch after this little boss here. Difference in this skill set that I have on now, instead of the teleporter, I got the big old boot that come down. So I'm like, is that big boot the thing that's drawing aggro? Because I didn't draw any aggro before I used that big old boot. So I wonder if that's all it is, just that one move that's pulling aggro. So you know, yeah, you can't turn off auto, you just turn that off and actually do everything. Once you think this is only auto, I'm just taking the lazy way out. You can do everything just by turning off this little icon in there. Little monitor. Dark Legion, this is one of these activities where we can just full auto. We don't really have to dodge anything or nothing in this Dark Legion. Well, when you do like Defend the Princess, or you do the Wizard of Oz, which is like your gear dungeon runs, when you do those, when it comes to the boss fight, yeah, you gonna have to move. Because the boss will smack you if you just try to full auto. Oh, this is bandits. I'm tripping. Yeah, I thought that was Dark Legion, but no, this is just guild bandits. Dark Legion, even in Dark Legion, there's a boss that you have to avoid. Yeah, that boss will smack you. So no, I'm tripping. This is just bandits. I'm tripping.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, we got a sword, so I don't have to worry about pulling aggro. We got a sword person, so I'm good. Y'all don't have to see me run for my life every time we fight bosses now. Wait till we do the next activity. I don't know how long they'll be running around doing this. Or if we fight the clan boss, I'll turn the video back on for that. If we fight the clan, the bandit boss. Activity, we have a little, well, now we have a little spider that's trying to escape, and we gotta like TP him to stop him, and we just gotta kill him before he completely escapes. So we just keep TPing him and just kill him pretty easy.
No retreats.
On your map, to find a wanted thing, whenever you go to an area, you'll see like a little coin right there. That's the wanted thing, a little coin bouncing. So you just click on that and you start the event. And you can do 5 of these a day and you get 50 of the little 50 of the magic crystals. And the magic crystals, there is a shop for magic crystals, so you can 1,000 magic crystals a day. So you get 250 crystals a day just by doing the 5 wanted
events. Burn. No retreats.
Huh. Okay, I think we're about to do the Dark Legion event. So we see these little cards, like that number 6 floating around. That would be how you can start the event for the Dark Legion. You gotta go to a number, because like the number is based off of the difficulty of the Dark Legion group. So 5 has a certain VR requirement. That's suggested. Same with 6. So I mean, kind of at this point in the game, we might be able to do a 6, but we could get clapped. I mean, 5 is easy mode. 6 depends. Just depends. You gotta be paying attention. You can't just auto the boss, because he will smack you if you just try to. Even on 5, he can do really good damage on you if you just try to auto him and don't move out of his AoEs, and you will get killed. I mean, when you're something like this. So sword person here, so they might be able to keep the aggro. But normally, whenever we do this, when we don't have a sword person with a shield, they normally on my head. So we'll see how. I mean, it normally goes pretty good for me when we have a sword person. Just trying to auto and sitting in the AO in circles. Yeah, they hit you with a couple of them, you did. So yeah, this is one thing you have to be careful when you're trying to auto this, is you actually have to move out of the circles. You can't just like that. I'm just gonna move anyway, you know, I'm not in all the way in it. I'm not gonna risk it. So that will be damage. So yeah, so this is nice having a who can tank the ball, so I don't have to worry about, like I said, running for my life. I mean, even with this, you can't all the way relax, because some of the circles just start randomly appearing on the people, so you still have to watch out and make sure that those little snowballs aren't falling on you. Three, well, yeah, we just leave it up, all three. That's pretty good. We gotta get some.
Burn! No retreats!
Okay, so this here is exactly the fight. Y'all team versus the boss. Got to go and merch.
Wishes?
And now that he did, okay, now I think he got the aggro back. Yeah, so the tank try to auto, that boss is going to clap his cheeks. Okay, he just tried to auto, I'm thinking. The boss clapped them cheeks. He tried to clap them again. Cheeks. Look at that. I mean, we did good the first round, but now that he did, guess who the boss on? Me, the mage. He on my ass. So I got to pay attention. All right, there you go. They will clap them cheeks if you don't pay attention. You try to auto and just think you good if you want. Okay, so normally what we got next here, we did Dark Legion, either Defend the Princess or Wizard of Oz. Oh, we got one more Dark Legion. Okay. Plenty of times messing around with this.
Burn. No retreat.
Why you on me, dog? Yeah, stay on that tank. Defend the Princess. We're gonna do that one. So this is like a tower defense type style. You have the princess in the middle, and you have waves of enemies coming in. And it's a standard setup. Like the first round, first the five waves, they all come in from the top two. It's a standard format on this Again, they'll drop power-ups, and you want to go up and pick up these power-ups. So you want to attack, defense, crit, all that good stuff.
Burn! No retreat!
Because Fire Mage, the only thing the Fire Mage has is the stun. That's it. So like you gotta do so much for that stun to go off. That's the only CC you got. You get damage over time. You get some of that. I mean, it helps, but in this game, the crowd control on every fifth round, there's a little boss that'll come out. The first boss will come out the top left quarter. That's a round 10. The second boss will come out the top left quarter. And then round 15, the last boss will come all the way forward as you get to the far right. So it's pretty, the same format. They don't change it. So I don't know if there's something that's going to change it. But what they'll do to improve on this is that's the game plan. Right now, just pretty standard. The same thing over there. The thing that as well. But this one, you can delay the whole 15. If you complete it. If you don't complete it, I mean, I think you actually get points for helping out if you, you know, come across some people that need help. You get up there. Yeah, these little materials right here, you get these from helping out people doing events that you know you've already done for the day. It's kind of like the kindness and the DLC. You get these little tickets here to go to work out. Should be knocking on my door.
No retreats.
The next 10 to 15 minutes.
Now.
Fit the Princess, and next we'll be doing the Wizard of Oz, which is the gear dungeon. Instead of Far, we got Mufa. They don't want to get sued. Yeah, Mufa.
Explosive thunder. You know who that's Have you heard of this hit song before?
Now.
So we just gotta do that two more times. I'll pause it. Okay, all right. So now, for solo activities, three for those. You got your the treasure map here. This is how you go and farm little maps to go digging. Like, you know, of course, like in GLC, you got treasure maps. So they got a little event where you do that three times a day, and you get a map or something to, you know, if you want to use it now or save them up. Three times, and that's all for that
one. Burn, no retreats.
I mean, once you start the sequence, it automatically do everything, unless you just want to turn off the automatic and do it manually.
Wishes can only be granted through effort.
So with the frogs on here, the traveling frog, you just find them around whatever area you pick, and you just talk to them, and they give you 25 magic crystals and an item or some reward. The only thing left is well, arena. No, I ain't doing no arena. Anything. I don't care for that. I'm on the worst character in the game for arena. The only thing I can beat up in there is bots. And on the daily, they have the Coliseum right here, which is a 3v3. They do this, I believe it's every night, from 9 p.m. Eastern, which is like, I think it's 10 according to the time, how the time is off right now. But that's every night, so if you want to jump in there and fight it out with some of the whales, they in there waiting. If that's what you want, they'll give you what you're looking for. Then this line tower here is just kind of like a tower, spiral abyss type thing, whatever. You go up in difficulty, you fight enemies, you get rewards. It has pretty good rewards. This is like, when you've done all your stuff for the day, this is like the last thing you want to do, just go up as far as you can go. You can claim that daily and get rewards. Do I have enough to beat that? Barely. Alright, challenges. Yeah, you get some pretty good rewards from this here, daily fire stuff to help, you know, power up your account a little bit. Not bad.
Attack!
I think in this part, as long as you're battle is higher than what they suggest, you should be okay. You just gotta dodge, you know, when you're fighting bosses, you just gotta dodge their big attack. You never see that orange circle if you're fighting boss, get out of the way. So it'll jump up real quick, like it'll go from being able to beat this guy to the next level, having a higher VR requirement than I have. So you got to listen to that. Ooh. Recommend it for the. That's for the next one. Recommend it. I do. So that is pretty much it. The arena, you already seen that last time. I just do the lowest difficulty and get that crap over with. I don't even play around with it. But that's it. That's what I do on a daily basis. Thank you for watching the video.